We are in Fresno, Clovis, California, and we just finished installing this Bradford White 50-gallon natural gas water heater. And you can see here, model number, serial number, spell check. Go to bradfordwhite.com, go ahead and fill the information out for your warranty, model number, serial number, your name, street address, all that kind of good stuff, and get your warranty going on this. What we've done here is just a partial rebuild of the stand, pulled it back, and everything was soaked, so we pulled back all of the sheetrock. And then, of course, we stiffened up the existing platform. It only had one top plate, so you can see we've capped it off and doubled up the thickness here. So brand new 2x4s all the way around on the top, two layers of half-inch OSB, and then a layer of half-inch sheetrock. We're leaving this open right now. You can see it's pretty well dried up, you know, already, just from this morning. I mean, water was rolling out of here. So let it dry until, you know, you're comfortable with it. Left sheetrock and some corner bead. They may not like this corner bead, but that's fine. But drywall guy, he's got plenty of sheetrock, corner bead. He can get this buttoned up and taped in. We did caulk around the base because you can't get in there once the water heater's in place. So we just took some painter's caulk and and caulked in the sheetrock on the platform against the wall. So that's already done. So brand new half-inch supply line over to brand new fittings here. So a little nipple 90, nipple 90. Another nipple, then the adapter, and of course over to the 24-inch supply line. So that's brand new. Adjustable straps, lower third, upper third, those are brand new. And then we went ahead and got the relief valve tied, relief line tied back in. We just extended it up here, put an adapter on, and then got a Falcon stainless steel connector over to the relief valve. That's temperature and pressure relief. So this guy here, too much temperature, too much pressure, this will pop off and it'll bleed outside. Right down there, low to the ground outside the door is where it dumps. So you can activate that once a year to make sure it's working correctly. It's spring-loaded, 150 PSI. Up here, we did take off the old valve and soldered on an adapter back here, copper, male iron pipe, copper iron pipe, not iron pipe, but it's a male thread adapter to a brass full-port ball valve. So quarter turn on or quarter turn off, quarter turn on, and then a little brass nipple, and then Falcon stainless steel connector down to coupling and a nipple, coupling and a nipple. This is all brass, so iron pipe corrodes from the inside out, from the outside in, all around. It doesn't flow good, it breaks down. We use brass because it lasts forever and it flows real clean. That's why we got brass ball valves there. So copper flows clean, so does brass. Brass nipple, so does stainless steel. And these are the biggest in the industry. These Falcon stainless steel connectors are full, like 0.725 inside diameter, which is larger than any other manufacturer. They're a little more expensive. That's what we use. That's what we like. So those are in. A little copper adapter here. We cut back out of the old supply line on the hot side as well. So all brand new piping up top. We did reuse one of the pieces of pipe up top right here that was existing, going up into the single wall, up into the ceiling bucket. Your roof, your dual wall B vent in the attic is pushed up about an inch and a half into the cavity, which is incorrect. I can't change that because you're boxed in up top. Your roof is like a 6 and 12, I don't know, 8 and 12, very, very steep roof. It's sealed, but it should be pushed down. That vent that extends through the roof flashing should be pushed down, because right now this pipe right here is shoved up into there about total of 3 inches. So it's in there. I mean, no big deal. It's in. Brand new piece of pipe here, adjustable offset here. Everything's in. The burner, the pilot is lit. The burner is on right now, so it's heating. We got this set to approximately 120. That's where we're leaving it. Hot is approximately 120. And then A130, B140, C150, very hot, 160, B140. You get 30 degree burns in 3 seconds. You can see right here, scalding risk increases with hotter water. So leave it low, check it. If this is too hot, turn it down a little. You can see here's low, and you can, there's somewhere in between low and hot. So adjust it. You don't need to run full blast hot water unless you're trying to fill a big soaking tub and you're trying to overcompensate because you're draining your tank down with 90 gallons of water. You know, and that's a very rare instance. So just adjust it so it's as hot as you want it, but not hotter. You shouldn't turn your faucet all the way to hot and then have to temper it way back with cold. You should be able to turn it all the way to hot, put your hand in, and it's comfortable. So anyways, enough lecture about that. So everything's in, everything's good. Outside of that, this installation is done.